What's up, Grizzlies fans? Welcome into another episode of Talkin Grizz. I am joined today by the team reporter and host for the Orlando Magic, Mackenzie Thirkill. She is out enjoying the sun right now in Orlando. I am so jealous because it is rainy. Thank you for joining us today.
Of course. Thank you for having me.
All right. So here's the thing. This is the first time we are going to see the Orlando Magic since, and I remember it like it's yesterday, Mackenzie, March 10th, it was the last game that we had before the league took its hiatus last year. Over a year. And the Orlando Magic, you look down the roster, and with not only it being one of the youngest teams, but with injuries, with big trades this season, it is a completely different team than we saw last year. So I'm hoping you can help us get reacquainted with your squad. I know right now they're led by Cole Anthony and Gary Harris, but who should we be looking out for in the next two games?
I would say those guys that you just mentioned, so Cole and Gary, but then of course also Wendell Carter Jr., who has been leading, he's our leading scorer now after all of the trade deadline, because obviously it used to be Vooch and the likes of Evan Fournier. So Wendell Carter Jr. has been really big for us these last couple weeks, and I think is really starting to come into his own a lot, you're starting to see. So I think that's really the guy you should be looking out for. Of course, Cole is really our headliner for in terms of names. He, of course, had a great game last night. So those I would say would probably be the two.
All right, and now I looked down at some of the stats. So Grizzlies, I know on my half, is they're number one in the league in fast break points. They play at a much faster pace than Orlando, who really likes to slow things down and play more in the half court. But Orlando had success last month against Brooklyn, who was another league leader in pushing that pace. How does this team slow other teams down and start to dictate the pace, and who's kind of the leader on the defensive end?
I would say defense has always kind of been the bread and butter and the makeup of this team, even prior to acquiring all of these new faces that you now see on our roster. But that just all is attributed to our coaching staff. That's their defensive mindset. Is, of course, head coach Steve Clifford, he's a defensive guy, even though we've been without him, and who's to say if we'll actually have him this weekend when we play you guys in this home and away series. But I think with this team, a lot of it is they try to slow it down because it's so much about organization for us right now and like figuring out our identity. They're still trying to figure out a lot their style of play amongst each other. So I think that's really been the premise of just trying to slow it down. That way they can see the court, especially with a guy like Cole, who's really growing into his role as the floor general. So I would say in terms of how we've been able to make that work to our benefit, I think we really, you see us play to our opponent. When we played the Lakers earlier this week, of course, everyone was kind of expecting them to come in with Anthony Davis returning, and they were just like, oh, it's going to be a blowout. It's the Lakers, of course, defending champs going up against the Magic, who have not been great since really the beginning of the season when we had everybody. But I think it's really playing to our opponents, and I think you're going to see that a lot going up against a team like you guys, for the fact that you do force turnovers. You guys play off of other teams' frustrations, and I think that's such a good learning curve. I don't know. I think it'll be in a little bit of an adjustment. I think you'll see on Friday night when we play you, but then you'll be able to see it turn a little bit when you guys return to Orlando on Saturday, and that's when you see us picking up. And we always seem to do better on the second game of a back-to-back.
That's so interesting.
It's always like that's kind of always been our thing. And I don't know if it's because you're already in the rhythm. I know when we had Aaron Gordon said that he always feels better coming into the second game of a back-to-back because you're already in that rhythm. And of course, we'll have the home court advantage. It's one of our last home games of the season for us. So I hope that it kind of plays to our favor, at least on Saturday. But I think you'll see that a lot. It's really just kind of figuring out the flow and trying to set each other up. We're on limited practice. We're without a head coach. So I think on Saturday, it's just going to be us trying to carry our momentum from our win on Wednesday night going into Friday, and then taking what we learned from Friday into Saturday.
I will say this. You say that there's a home court advantage where the Grizzlies are one of the three teams, I think, in the league right now who actually have a better record on the road. Yeah. So I don't want to spoil that last home game for you guys. Here's my last question for you. And it's interesting that you say that Orlando, even at the end of the season, is still trying to figure out their identity, you know, even moving forward into next season. The Grizzlies' identity right now is really based on, one, the fast break, like I mentioned, and then points in the paint. Even in the last few games that Orlando has won, they were still outscored in the paint, but they were able to pull ahead mainly from the three-point line. So when they're trying to find that identity and playing off of someone like the Grizzlies, who scores so much in the key, who do you think is going to be the biggest kind of, one, defensive stopper, like you talked about defense, but two, who's putting up points in the paint for these guys?
I would say defensively, Chuma Okeke has been absolutely amazing for us defensively. You're really seeing him grow. You've just seen him grow since January. Gary Harris, of course, who is known for his defense since we acquired him from the trade deadline. He's a silent killer, I feel like, when it comes to defense. And again, that's just what he's known for. And he's very, what's the best way to put it? He's very silent in terms of helping this team run. Like, he's the guy that was able to kick the ball to Cole Anthony for us, for him to have the ball in his hands those last couple seconds. I would say in terms of points in the paint, Chuma is going to be a one. Wendell's going to be a guy. James Ennis, when he can get into the lane, is someone. And James Ennis, of course, is coming off of injury. We had him out for 5 games, and we recently just got him back. Terrence Ross, if he's back, he's been out due to back spasms, but anytime we can get him, he's our guy off the bench, like, hands down. And then Mo Bamba, too, has been really good statistically these last few games, which has been really exciting to see him finally be able to have more minutes and grow into his role as well.
We are excited to have you guys here at FedEx Forum, and then everyone is packing their bags and heading back down to Orlando for that back-to-back. Mackenzie, it was so good chatting with you.
Yeah, thanks again for having me.
Anytime. Go enjoy the sun. And Grizzlies fans, you know you can always get more on grindcitymedia.com.